much for coming today. We're really thrilled to be here to play for you. If you look at your program, you're going to see that every other piece is by Mozart, and I'll talk about that in a minute.
Yeah.
So what you see here, this ensemble is called a flute quartet, even though obviously it's not four flutes. And within these four instruments, there's all kinds of combinations of pieces we can do that will not use all four of us, and so that's kind of what we're going to explore today, is the different sounds. And part of what's kind of interesting in this concert is we're going to do a duet by Mozart, and then we'll do a trio by Mozart, and then we'll finish with a quartet by Mozart. And you can hear how he layers one instrument upon another and makes the sound bigger and bigger. But we're going to start with the Four Fancies by Gordon Jacob, English composer, and I had some stuff on my phone, but I'm not going to read it to you. English composer, very prolific, wrote a lot for winds, and this is just a delightful little opener for our concert.
Now, I've always wanted to say this, but this first piece is called A.
Thank you.
interesting history with how this piece came to be. Michael Haydn, who was Franz Joseph's brother, had been commissioned to write a set of six duos for violin and viola. And he became ill, and he'd written four of them, and just couldn't finish them. And the patron who had commissioned them said, well, I'm not going to pay you anything then if you don't give me all six. So he was good friends with Mozart, and so he asked Mozart, would you write the last two for me? Which he did. And I can tell you, because I have also, I've never performed the Michael Haydn duos. I've read them. They're not nearly as good as the Mozart, and I can't imagine that the patron didn't figure out that there were two different composers for the set. But anyway, so these duos, there's two of them by Mozart, and we're going to do the first movement of the G major duo. Thank you. one player to the trio. And actually, the next two pieces you're going to hear are from type of piece called a divertimento, sometimes called a serenade. And these were pieces written in the classical period of the time of Haydn, Beethoven, Mozart. Multi-movement pieces. So usually like in the symphony or a quartet, you might have three or four movements. These pieces would be much longer. They would have six, seven, eight movements in them. And we're going to give you samples from first from the Beethoven divertimento for flute, violin, and viola. And one cool thing about this is there's in one of the movements, there's actually a variation where Danny and I play together without the flute. So you get to hear how Beethoven treats violin and viola as a duet.
Hey, you found it.
Thank you.
So the next piece, now we're going back to Mozart, but it's now for trio, for string trio. And this is from a really monumental piece. It is probably, well, in my opinion, it's the greatest string trio ever written. Although Beethoven wrote some pretty good ones too. But this is an amazing piece. This is from his Divertimento. It's late Mozart. And actually, you're hearing Mozart from different parts of his life. So this is very late. I think he only had one or two more symphonies to go when he wrote this. And again, it's a piece of multiple movements. If you, Danny and I have actually performed the whole thing, it takes about 40 minutes. It's a very long, it's a long song. So we're going to just give you the first of, there are two minuets in this piece because it's so long, he put a second minuet in it. So this is the first minuet from the Divertimento in E flat by Mozart.
Did you talk about the difference between the string trio and the string quartet?
Would you like me to? Do you want to?
I particularly like that part when you talked about that. There isn't a whole lot of music written for string trio, but we have Beethoven wrote some string trios and Mozart wrote some string trios, but it was so much more versatile to write for string quartet, which is a fuller overall sound. And you're sort of missing, you know, with the string trio, you're missing one extra violin, which adds a lot. But this music is really, it's quite astoundingly beautiful and wonderful, and it's amazing there's so little written for it.
Well, and I think the reason is, from a composer's point of view, it's so much harder to make three instruments sound as full and rich as four.
Mm.
So it's really true. There's very little written for this combination, and there is some 20th century stuff. Dominani wrote a great divertimento for the three, but it is rare. And but this is, to my view, this is the greatest of this genre, of which there is more.
Thank you.
Another formation of a trio. and if you thought there wasn't much written for string trio, there's even less written for this. probably the most famous pieces written for this combination are the Haydn London trios, and they're lovely. They're kind of a little light in seriousness, and we play them at a lot of weddings and stuff, background music. But however, this is a great combination of instruments, the flute, violin, and cello. And so this is the only piece by a living composer on the program today, Edgar Gertain. He's an American composer, young guy, he's in his 30s. And he's actually written two trios for this combination, multi-movement works. And we're going to do just the second movement of his second trio. Very jazzy, very syncopated rhythms. It's a really fun piece. I think you're going to enjoy it.
Is entitled The Dance.
If it makes you want to move, that's a good thing.
It's a little bit of a lopsided dance.
It's a lopsided dance.
It's very sick. In three.
You won't always be able to tell us in three, trust me.
Thank you.
Mozart would think if he heard this.
Mozart would, he probably would have enjoyed it.
He would probably love it. He would have like, oh my God. All this.
Now we're going back to Mozart. So our final piece of the program is a masterpiece. And actually, I wanted to go back to that Mozart trio we played. The first violist that performed that piece was Mozart. He was on the original performance, which I thought was kind of cool. So our final piece is the Mozart D major flute quartet. Now this is an earlier work. The trio was a very late work, and the duo was kind of in the middle. So you're hearing different parts of his life represented here. And this was a commission. It was written for an amateur flutist to play. And it has survived all these years as one of the great pieces for this combination. Again, not a lot written for this combination either. So today we're bringing you music that's a little less heard in the concert hall. Hope you've been enjoying it. So please enjoy the Mozart D major flute quartet.
Thank you. Thank you.